Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In this video, we will be looking at the collapsible effects pipeline that lives just above your sequence in Autodesk Smoke. If you're unsure what I'm referring to, the effects pipeline is the large bar in the interface that's located just above the Source tab and Sequence tabs in the Timeline view. As a reminder, the effects pipeline shows you all the effects you've applied to a segment in the sequence. You also have a simple parameters bar to do adjustments, as well as a means to enter the advanced editor to dig deep down into any applied effect. However, if you're not using this area above the sequence, say for example, you're performing an editing task rather than applying effects, this area of the interface stops being useful and just creates a gap between the sequence and the viewers. To better manage this area, you can collapse the effects pipeline using the available button. This means that you have more space to display your sequence and make better use of the interface. The same button will also expand the effects pipeline back to its original size. Now, even if you have collapsed the effects pipeline, you can still perform effects tasks using some of the shortcuts and contextual menus. For example, to add an effect to a segment in the sequence, you would select it, right-click, and choose Add Effect. This will bring up the effects ribbon to choose your effect. Applying a color correction as a timeline effects will automatically expand the effects pipeline so that you can get grading straight away. Please note that the effects pipeline will automatically expand with all timeline effects with the exception of connect effects. This is because connect effects does not have any basic parameters. You simply double-click on the segment and enter into connect effects. No need to see the effects pipeline. Another scenario to examine is if the effects pipeline is collapsed and you want to edit the existing timeline effects parameters. All you need to do is expand the track you are working on and double-click on the timeline effects icon that will expand the effects pipeline. The last point I would like to touch on is when the effects pipeline is collapsed, the render button is also hidden. However, rendering your effects is not a problem because you can still set it off in three different ways. Right-clicking on a segment and choosing the render option is one way. You can also go down to the gear menu and choose the render options from there. Or you could simply press the keyboard shortcut that will start the render for the selected segment in the sequence. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe for future videos coming from the Smoke Learning Channel.